I really don't give a shit about how much controversy I start.
Yeah, you're not going to make friends when you leave one of these tracks.
The red number one plate means one thing, champion.
When I see the red number one plate on Ricky's truck, I just giggle a little bit.
The number one plate, there was controversy.
Greaves comes back to the inside. Trying to battle back for the lead. Contact to the infield. Racing towards the tabletop. Ricky Johnson lands on top of Greaves. Final turn before the checker. Greaves in the lead. Jumps into the inside. Slams into Greaves and puts him into the wall.
That's Ricky being Ricky. He's just f***ing baby-ass f***.
This is a street fight, man. There's no strategy.
You know, when you're a spoon-fed rich boy, I guess anything comes out of you. He don't it never worked for nothing in his life, so he wouldn't know what it's like to have to fix shit.
This is professional racing. You need to act like professionals.
Again, contact between Greaves and Johnson. Johnson and Greaves one more time. Are you kidding me?
Yes! If you don't feel I don't deserve it, it's just you don't like me.
Put it this way, Ricky's not on my Christmas card list, and it doesn't look like he'll be on it anytime soon.
In what was an amazing championship season for Ricky Johnson, there's got to be some unfinished business for Johnny Greaves.
Season opener, sitting in the truck, and so many things are going through my mind. Visions of last year, the controversies that I had with different drivers.
Welcome to Charlotte Motor Speedway, race fans, and Pro 4 at the line. Green flag is out, we're underway. Ricky Johnson with the lead, Johnny Greaves in second. Here they come into the infield off the backstretch. Coming through the mogul section, it's Johnson. Greaves tries to duck to the inside.
You're right.
Now
coming
through the infield.
Right, coming on your right hard.
They come together. Greaves and Johnson. Greaves goes way outside. Douglas slides underneath, almost hits the wall. Smoke pouring out of Ricky Johnson's truck. Again, Greaves keeps it down low. Trying to find a way around Johnson. Johnson's throwing heavy smoke. Johnson pitches it hard in the infield. Greaves still's not giving an inch. Coming through the center section, still nose to tail, while smoke continues to billow out of Ricky Johnson's machine. Johnny Greaves ducks the inside to battle for the lead. For a moment, it looks like he may have it. Up over the tabletop, Johnson lands on top of Johnny Greaves. The right rear tire runs over the rooftop and windshield of Greaves.
And what a jolt to Greaves inside the cab of his truck.
Johnson over-rotates, handing the lead and the win to Johnny Greaves.
All I remember is that I heard a big crash and my head, you know, went down real violent, and I honestly thought we were flipping through the air because it was all quiet for a while, and all of a sudden I see his truck kind of skidding off my hood and down my front bumper, and I'm like, he just landed on me, you know, and there he was sitting sideways in front of me, and, you know, my first instinct was just to drill him. But my second instinct was just to beat his ass, and that was the better one.
raced his hard to the finish, came off and fished his kid off CJ. I came around, he had the bird flying at me.
Hey, little boy! If you're big enough to pull your face and take a shot!
Yes, I did land on him, but all that, wasn't trying to take him out. So I thought, who is this kid to get in my face? So if he's going to be man enough to step in front of a moving truck, give me the finger, then I'm going to get out and have some words with him.
Wait,
take it!
I want to explain. Yeah, it was a good race, but you landed on his foot.
I'm going straight!
All right.
I didn't touch him!
I'm out on the track celebrating and throwing champagne all over, and there's nobody there paying attention. I was like, what's going on? Uh-oh. There's a fight.
I
thought it was my brother at first because he's usually the one in the middle of that, but we had him secured off in the hot pit, so I'm thinking, oh, boy, who's my next wild child? And sure enough, it was CJ.
I wasn't aiming for you, bro. I went straight off the jump.
What's the deal with this kid?
No, he's flipping up. I came out and I talked to him.
I flipped you up, too.
I know that. Then come talk to me. All I did is I went over.
Don't go after him.
I didn't go after him.
Oh, when I knew my wife Kathy was involved, I was a little afraid for Ricky's life.
He's flipping me off. He needs to learn.
I just was standing there, and Kathy came up to me and poked me in the chest and told me that, with a lot of profanity, that she was going to kill Rick if he ever talked to her son like that.
When I was walking around the corner and I saw RJ going towards somebody, I didn't even really know who it was at first. I knew CJ was over there, but I didn't know it was him. And the minute I saw that it was CJ, you have this feeling that comes over you that you can't even explain. But a mother and a child, the first thing you want to do is protect him. And I wanted to get over there and get in the way of it, whether I'm like one-third the size of RJ, but I could have took him down, I'm pretty sure of that.
Unfortunately, it's not the first time he's been disrespectful to Rick, so it really made Rick upset.
I never laid a hand on him, I never touched him, I never, you know, I backed him up, but I didn't back him up with my hands. I know he's a kid. It was more of an old dog barking at a young dog, basically saying, you know, you're messing with the wrong guy here. What I wanted to do was teach him a lesson, because maybe the next guy's not going to have as much control as I had. Yeah, I was mad. Yes, I yelled at him. Yes, I screamed in his face, but I never touched him, and I wouldn't touch him. If my son Luke would have gotten in Johnny's face, I would expect Johnny to get out and go after him. You know, I've raised my kids, and my dad was the same way when I raced motorcycles. I started racing pro when I was 13. I had some issues with some guys, and I was really mad and wanted to fight him. He says, well, then go fight him. I'm like, I'm too small. I'm going to get my ass kicked. He's like, well, then either you can do something about it or shut up. So if you're going to be a man, you're going to do these things, you have to stand up for yourself. So if my son Luke got in Johnny's face, I would expect Johnny to go after him with the same respect and the same intensity. And bottom line, kind of admire CJ's balls for stepping up. You know, any kid that's going to get into a man's face and step up for his dad, you know, I think he deserves some kudos, regardless of all the drama and all the bullshit that went on. You know, CJ stepped up for his dad, and you got to admire that.
You know, what we preach is you race the way you want to be raced. And if you want to go out and beat and bang and knock somebody's fenders off and try to cut their tires or whatever, you got to expect that's going to happen to you.
Ricky and I probably still have a little war to settle here, and it may go on for the rest of the year.
Welcome, race fans, to the Bark River International Off-Road Raceway.
Yeah, it was pretty much a standard restart at Bark River. Me and Ricky came to the flag. We both took off. He feels that I probably jumped and got a run on him, and it forced him into an error.
Greaves gets into the left rear of Johnson!
I came off the jump, gave him the whole inside lane. He overjumped the jump and went straight into me.
Looking inside. Still there. Just hold your line here. Hold your line.
Ricky's got a tire pop.
If we touched in the air, you can't physically see it, you know.
They both were in, Rick.
I was pretty pissed off. Anytime you get taken out of a race, especially on something like that.
F*** you, Ricky Johnson. That boy.
John, you got the bomb, too.
You ran into me and talked my rear end out of me.
Yeah, I know it.
At the end of the day, if there wasn't a black flag, I guess that's the way we race. You know, that's the way we've been taught. So, let's race.
I didn't think he really intentionally did it. And then when you hear somebody celebrate, you know, and then say, "F*** you, Ricky Johnson," to his crew and stuff and laugh, it pissed me off. When I saw it, I knew what was coming on TV for the next day, and it wasn't so much "F*** me" then.
Two corners remaining, Greaves in the lead. Here comes Johnson, a great fight off the corner. Johnson slams into the inside of Greaves, and Johnson will take the win.
You know, I've always kind of said that if you're going slow enough that somebody can hit you and spin you, it's kind of your fault.
Meanwhile, there's a disgusted Johnny Greaves after being slammed to the wall by Ricky Johnson.
How we doing right there, brothers?
In set match, my friend.
That's Ricky being Ricky. He's just a f***ing baby-ass f***. You know, when you're a spoon-fed rich boy, I guess anything comes out of you. He never worked for nothing in his life, so he wouldn't know what it's like to have to fix it.
When I came on the radio and I said, "That's how we do it right there," it's about racing as hard as you can and waiting for that opportunity. You're pushing, trying to get a door to open up for you, and then when the door cracks, you're ready there to capitalize on that. It's not about taking somebody out, it's about beating them.
If I could have got my hands on him, even though he's 200 pounds bigger than me, I would have given it everything I got just to express my feeling back to him, you know. But I took a little time to think about it and hope that, you know, the series and the rulemakers and everybody who witnessed it would do the right thing.
50 people look at it, 25 people could see it one way and 25 could see it the other. There was a door that was open and Ricky stuck in it. You could say, okay, maybe he drove in a little too far and hit him, but as a sanctioning body and an officiating arm, it's racing. And what we have to look at is Ricky was aggressive, but he was racing for the win and ultimately got the win. The sad part of the thing was, is it put Johnny out of the race to where he couldn't finish, and so he got a worse finish than he probably should have, but it is racing and Ricky took advantage.
To this day, I don't think they did the right thing. They still affected the outcome of that overall championship. Things would have went a lot different in the end, but you know, everybody's allowed to have their opinion and make choices, and that's what happened that day.
I think the determination of the championship was done in a correct manner, and you know, it was a season filled with drama, but yeah, I think it was one that ended in the correct manner.
The bottom line is Johnny and I are competitors, and we're going to be competitors. But I know as soon as Johnny straps that helmet on, it's 100%. He was that way on a motorcycle. He's that way in a truck. If there's a crack in the door, he's going to kick it down and come in. But fortunately for all the fans, I'm the same way. It's about winning.
I'm not over the Ricky Johnny show at all. It lights my ass up, quite honestly. If that's the talk on the street that there's only two people out there to talk about, well, got another thing coming. We're gonna break up the usual suspects.
Mark and I had a lot of battles going on. Scott Douglas gets into the left rear of Mark Jenkins. Again, they get into it. I felt we're a little one-sided. He felt they were one-sided as well. But on his side, it was really strange. Jenkins again hangs on to the lead, heading into turn one. Again, they make big-time contact. Tires smoking, 900-plus horsepower as they make contact again. Our top three trucks.
No, Mike, don't let Douglas make the podium.
I talked to him quite a bit. It didn't seem to work.
We're going to work it out one way or the other, you know, and, you know, someone comes up, you know, bandaged, you know, after this conversation, then, you know, so be it.
And I was trying to explain my philosophy of racing to the next corner, racing to the leader. Jenkins and Douglas slide off the track, and they'll lose positions. Two trucks up in the wall, coming back off. Houston maintains the lead, but Douglas comes right back. Again, more contact made as they battle for the lead. Douglas on the inside. Again, they make contact. Forces Houston off the track outside the cement barrier. And out of nowhere, here comes Mark Jenkins with the lead. At Charlotte, it kind of boiled over because the fact that, you know, he was hitting me dead on straight in the, on the straightaway. Jenkins rides up in the back bumper of Douglas into turn one.
Get away from me. That's slow. Contact is slow.
I thought I was racing Scott clean. I wasn't getting him sideways the night before, but I was racing him really close. And we had some metal-to-metal contact, my front bumper to his rear bumper. And every time we'd touch, I'd roll out of the gas like a gentleman, because I'm that kind of guy. I'm a gentleman racer.
If you have that much speed, go around me and pass me. Come on, you know?
Scott Douglas and Ricky Johnson side by side.
Probably the worst tit-for-tat guy is probably Scott Douglas.
Still there?
If you run him clean, he'll run you clean. You give him a little bumper, he's going to give you some bumper. You spin him. If he gets close enough, he's taking you out. He's kind of old school that way.
Then finally, on the second day, you know, he ran me up high and made the pass. I go, you know what? I'm kind of done with this.
Jenkins ricochets off the inside of Douglas, forcing Scott way outside of the wall in turn one. That was way more than a wake-up call for Douglas.
I don't want to just hit him. I don't want to just bump him. I just want to rub him a little bit. I want to make a statement.
With Jenkins in third, and here comes Douglas to the inside, and he drills Jenkins.
I think I embarrassed him and put a shoulder on him for the position. I was in third spot moving forward, and I think he just turned red-faced. You know, the demon came out in him, and he forgot he had a brake pedal.
Jenkins will go all the way around a complete 360, never lifts on the throttle, will get back underway, and Douglas will go around to the outside for third.
Congratulations. That's awesome.
And I want everybody to know exactly what I did, and I could do it at any time, because Johnny can do it, Ricky can do it, I can do it. All of us veterans could take a person out or spin them out anytime we want. We just don't, because of respect and because of we want to get to the front.
You can back up if you can. Back up.
Hell no, it's not time to let the new guys in. It's time for the old guys to keep on winning and the veterans to show them how it's done.
I learned at Crandon that I will not trust Adrian Chinney again.
Adrian, these two guys in front of you, they're battling for a points championship. Let's be clean, all right? Race them hard. Don't give them nothing, but let's be clean.
Chinney's spotter just wanted us to know that they're not going to drive you dirty. They're going to keep it clean.
You know, he came on the radio, hey, I'm going to race you clean.
Through turn two, it's Johnny Greaves, Ricky Johnson, Adrian Chinney head down towards the gravel pit, Oakley turn number three. Chinney goes to the outside, throws it sideways. Johnson slides sideways. Here comes Chinney inside.
And then the next turn, bam, runs me into a concrete block.
And big time contact between Adrian Chinney and our points leader, Ricky Johnson. Adrian Chinney will take the checkered flag.
Woo-hoo! Are you kidding me? He's fucking a man.
But he just drove right into me. I love how he tells me, we're going to drive you clean, and he just fucking runs right into me.
I know no matter what anyone says, Adrian or his spotter or anybody in that camp, I will never trust him again.
Amazing race, very tough. A little nervous about having contact because I didn't want to screw up their races. But, you know, you got to get by a guy. How do you get by a guy? I can knock on the door, I can maybe place a phone call, or I can just go by on the inside. So I just had to go by on the inside.
Keep the party going. Woo!
We want the guys to race. We want them to settle.
I wish there was a sport full of clean drivers. I wish that everybody would have the car control to come up, touch somebody, and make it interesting without having to take them out. But a lot of the time, there's quite a bit of out of control. And even from drivers that are really smart, good drivers, tenured drivers that have been around for a while, they'll come up and do kind of rookie-type stuff, which makes you wonder, what's going on with that?
On the track, if I got something on my mind, I feel I've been wrong, I'm going to tell you about it. I mean, you're going to start doing a lot of block passes. You're going to start, you know, short breaking guys. You guys won't admit this stuff, but I will. I'm up front. I'm going to tell you, this is what we got to do. We got to do what we have to do to stay in front, because AMSOIL and Borla Exhaust and BF Goodrich, they pay us to win, you know, and that's what our team's all about. Plus, my guys put hundreds of hours in that truck, and I'm not going to let them down just because a guy roughed me up. I'm going to rough him back up, and I'm going to block and protect that line as much as I can to the very finish.
trust anybody?
No.
And trust Ricky?
No.
Ricky's going to lean on me as hard as anybody else would. Maybe harder.
Mike Jenkins gets crossed up as they cross the Red Bull Arch. Johnson goes inside. They slide, make contact in the air.
We're all spoiled brats, and none of us like to lose.
It doesn't matter who's next to me. It doesn't make any difference who that guy is. If that's my brother, it doesn't matter. We're going for the win.
And now the brothers are going after each other. Second, third today, boys. Woo!
It's a golden rule type of thing. You know, just expect to get whatever you're given. And at some point in time, officiating may get between you, but they generally let us work it out.
We've got a parking lot in turn two, and Mark Jenkins is stuck in the middle.
And at times you realize, hey, there's a lot of money in these trucks. You know, who really has the line right here? When is it time to tuck in behind the other one?
What a battle! In the gravel pit turn is Leduc, Greaves, and Douglas!
Yeah, you're not going to make friends when you leave one of these tracks.
Douglas on the inside! Again, they make contact!
And everyone keeps their scorecard, and you know when evens need to be applied.
Honestly, if you're doing everything it takes to win and pushing it to that level to be a champion, you are on the edge of crashing.
I race with all I have. I race every race like it's my last chance to be on the track. I go at it at 100%. I'm not out there to hurt anybody. I'm out there to win.
I'm strapped into that truck. It's hot. You got the fans off. Let your engine come up to temp. You're sweating. You go visor down, fans on, say, it's go time, baby.
When the driver pulls the helmet on to go out and say that I'm going to hit this 100-foot tabletop as fast as I can and fly as far as I can, he becomes a person that he normally isn't.
Make sure that all your affairs are in order.
You all right, Mark?
And I go through him and I say, it's been a great life.
But when he's in a truck, he becomes demonized.
When I put on a helmet, then I can unleash the aggressive side of my personality in its full force. I'd like to think that around the table with the family, I'm a calmer, gentler Mark. You're a beast on the track, and you completely convert your mindset. The aggression is what gets elevated, and you get to exert that to what you're being intensely focused on, and that is munching up the green flag and capturing the checker.
The race is, so much of it is gained in the first lap of the track, the first lap of the race. I mean, you just got to be there, you got to be on it, you just got to go.
And finally, Pro 4 racing for RedBud is underway. The 2012 season continues.
First race of the year is always intense. You're wondering, did I do enough homework? Did I do enough testing? Am I in shape? What are the other guys doing? There's all these different factors, and everybody goes into the first race thinking they are the champion, because at that point, the slate is clean. Everybody's got 0 points. Your optimism is ultimately high, and all you think is, I'm going to go win this race. I'm going to go on to win the championship. It's going to be an awesome banquet.
The Mopar Ram Runners on the track getting ready for the next race, and that can only mean one thing, Jim.
We're ready to go Pro 4 racing here at RedBud, Michigan. What a beautiful scenescape we've got out here today. All these drivers, you hear them talking beforehand on the track here. No love lost between any of them.
As we look at Adrian Cheney inboard, now we got Ricky Johnson. The intensity level will increase. Johnny Greaves right now, the intensity level will increase the closer they get to the green flag.
Remember, all these tensions and all these little different rivalries between the drivers carrying over from last year and our first rounds this year, bringing it right here to RedBud as they're about to take the green flag coming down. Douglas is going to lead it down the deep sand section, and the green flag is out.
Mike Jenkins gets a hole shot. He'll duck in front of Scott Douglas heading into turn number one. In that long left-hand sweeper, this is where our other class will be having problems all weekend long. How will the four-wheel drive handle it when this track gets busy to get all blue group and very split.
Johnny Greaves looking to the inside, trying to make an early move here with Douglas in front of him, trying to chase down Jake. Big air from Scott Douglas!
Big air! That was huge air out of Douglas! And here comes Greaves now to the inside! Out of nowhere, Greaves goes from third to first, and Douglas just overshot the whole entire corner.
Wow!
Johnson now ducks into third, Chenny fourth, as he's already getting fenders and headlights and fiberglass basically ripped off that truck.
All kinds of out of shape as they hit that big downhill sweeper. Coming back to complete lap number one.
Chenny trying to stay out of that roost of deep, heavy, wet sand. Now ducks the inside. Try to make a move on Johnson.
As you get a look in the cockpit and see that he's got a little bit of roof coming inside there.
Going back on board with Scott Douglas looking to the back of the field. You see how soft that dirt appears? And we got a wreck. For sure there will be coming out a full course yellow on this one.
And correct, there's the Mopar Ram Runner pace truck. Johnny Greaves leading the way, followed by Scott Douglas, Ricky Johnson, Adrian Chenny, and Mike Jenkins.
Greaves at the point, getting ready to go back. Green flag racing, and look how tight Chenny is on Ricky Johnson.
Everyone's going to try to get the jump as we go back to green through the sand.
Again, Chenny's just bang on the back bumper of Johnson.
See a lot of body panels already falling off these trucks.
With a track this wet and heavy right now, already like 2-3 laps in the race, you can see rust is starting to form, but the weight of that dirt, that mud, that sand will pack underneath these fenders and actually rip them off themselves just by the sheer weight.
These trucks will become hundreds of pounds heavier before the end of the race.
Adrian Chenny has no grill and no left front fender. I would predict that that thing will be minus a hood, maybe a roof by the end of the race.
There's a good chance of it as he tries to duck to the inside. Ricky Johnson holds him off for now.
Now keep in mind, Jim, a lot of these fans don't realize that these things have 900-plus horsepower. Your normal street car has what, 250, 300? Imagine that in a 4,000-pound truck, 900 horsepower in these things.
Talk about heavy metal, that's for sure.
Johnny Greaves has the point, basically making a Sunday drive of it so far. Johnson getting a pelvic with that mud. You can see he's got vision problems, but saving his tear off to the very last minute before he rips one off.
As he pilots the machine one-handed, he looks very much in control.
The guy's a workout god, man. He's on a bicycle a half hour before the race, just getting the blood flow, getting warmed up, and then he'll strap on the fire suit, jump inside that truck, and go racing after spending a half hour on the bike itself.
You know, the athlete these days in all forms of sports and motorsports taking it up different levels, and Ricky Johnson no exception.
Looking so comfortable inside that truck right now, even though he's back in the middle of the pack, so to speak. He's getting pelted with mud, sand, and barely can see, but yet he looks so comfortable. Another day at the office.
Yeah. And what a view he's got sitting from his desk.
You can see that right front fender on Johnson starting to flop up in the breeze. That could be a factor as the race wears on. And maybe, blocking his vision. You never know.
Definitely something to keep an eye on.
He's right on your bumper, right on your bumper. He's driver.
Ricky Johnson take a peek at the inside of Scott Douglas. Douglas able to manhandle his way back to the inside to block the turn. But here comes Chenny on Johnson.
Scott Douglas on the outside trying to hold off the charge of Ricky Johnson. Comes off with a great head of steam, which he has every time by. Ricky trying to change it up, see what he can do to get by.
I'm already seeing dust be kicked up on this track 2-3 laps into the race. And here comes Johnson inside Douglas. You can see him seesawing on that steering wheel. Forces the issue with Scott Douglas. And now Johnson moves up one spot.
That hood's starting to fly up, and we talked about it earlier. Hopefully that doesn't become an issue as you see Ricky taking another tear off.
Man, it looks like he's saving that one till the very last before he reaches up, waiting for that visor to get actually loaded with mud before he tears another one off. Chenny now coming into the mix of things. He's on the inside of Scott Douglas.
Keep in mind, Ricky in second place has a ways to go to reel in the leader of the race, Johnny Greaves.
What's really cool about this class now is there's so much strategy involved, Jim, that competition yellow, it's almost the first half race and the second half race. They're racing for 2 points as Jenny gets out by two wheels. As I started to say, they're racing for 2 points if they cross the line with the lead at the halfway point.
And look at the size of the ruts already forming. We talked about these trucks, 4 horsepower, twice the wheel drive of the Pro 2s, and it just damages the track that much quicker.
Jenny, still, I say it all the time, but he's still there on Douglas.
Wild man living up to his name.
Douglas trying to make that boil exhaust Amsoil Ford incredibly wide.
Driver, look, he's coming hard.
Jenny gets by but washes out. Douglas makes the pass back.
Good job. Keep it tight. He's there. You're
one part of
Adrian.
Douglas still has the position, but here comes Kenny to the inside. Kenny goes way tight to the inside of both trucks. Douglas and Kenny are just bouncing through all those ruts.
I thought for a second Douglas left the door open, but then Adrian washed out a little bit as well. Douglas holding on. You see the damage to the front of that truck, too.
Every single one of these drivers doing the same thing on each other, man. They come into the corner on the outside, they exit the corner on the inside to make the pass, and then they'll come right back and do it to each other again.
Trying to set it up here to the left side. Here's our leader.
Oh, yeah! Johnny Greaves up front, yeah! Almost forgot about him.
Let's not do that ever.
And look at that helmet. Look at that shield. Not one speck of dirt, man.
Notice that.
He needs this win probably more than anybody out there. But then on the other hand, Ricky Johnson, that number one plate, has got to reel him in. But here's the thing. Are they being smart? Are they playing that halfway point game, you know? Are they comfortable in second? Is Douglas happy with third? Or are you just going to wait until the halfway point to set it off and really take the gloves off for the second half?
Yeah, it's a big chess match out there. Do you save the equipment? Do you try for the extra points? Once they get them all grouped up, you never know what these guys might have left.
You know, I can't help but think this is Johnny Greaves' kind of track, a short, we'll call it a Bristol of off-road. You know, we got our Talladegas, which are the Crandons and Bark Rivers, but we also need to have a Bristol, and that's what we have right here in RedBud, right into Johnny Greaves' hands.
Fast, yet technical, not a whole lot of passing line.
You know, and one thing we got to mention about Greaves, that Toyota of his, you have to go to a TORC race to actually physically hear this thing. It is one really mean-sounding V8 like nothing else out there on that track.
There's no doubt about that, especially something you've got to hear in real life. But right now, the mandatory caution is out, otherwise known as the halfway point. That's where we re-rack them, restack them in a single-file line, and let them fly off again when the green flag comes out.
With that Mopar Rennrunner pace truck on the track, regrouping the field, Johnny Greaves at the point. We should be going green flag racing next time around.
As we get set to go green one more time here at RedBud, a little bit of cat and mouse game going on, single file line, Johnny Greaves, he'll set the pace coming up as you look on board.
You know, I'm not feeling quite yet from these guys out here. They've been aggressive, but they haven't been dicing around a heck of a lot. I'm hoping that the gloves are about ready to be thrown out the window and going back to bare knuckles boxing for the second half.
They're looking a little bit too mellow right now, but I know it's all about to come down. Here we come. Onto the straightaway.
Waiting for that green flag to fly. Johnny Greaves with a point. Ricky Johnson second. There's that 2011 rivalry all over again.
It's funny how they just seem to meet next to each other as the green flag is out once again.
And Ricky Johnson gets a great jump off the lines. He pulls inside of Greaves.
Talk about trying to make your move early. That's exactly what Ricky's trying to do.
And how about that? Johnny Greaves peeks out the driver's window to his left and kind of winks at Johnson, but he retakes the lead.
We'll have to see what Ricky thought about that. Here comes Scott Douglas up in the third place spot.
Adrian Chaney tries inside of Douglas. He almost touched. It looked like Chaney may have maybe popped a tire marker on the inside. Backed off a little bit, we'll fall back into fourth and make another charge later on.
Look at that, the Jenkins brothers back there side by side too. But right now, Ricky Johnson, Johnny Greaves, we say it all the time, coming through the sand once again.
You know, Jim, I noticed one thing. This race, in particular with so many tight corners. This is where the spotters are vital. The communication, not so much how you're doing, but letting you know, the driver, what your competitors are doing out there on the track.
Especially with such a wide open track such as this.
Johnson, once again, trying to find where that weak spot is on that Toyota of Johnny Greaves, where he may not be the quickest, where he can take advantage with his full-power power. There it is, outside of the corner entry, inside exit, nothing there.
That screaming Toyota holds its ground right now, but here comes Ricky, cannot make the move inside.
You know, Jim, watch on the in-cars, first Johnny, then Ricky, watch their driving styles. Which driver looks comfortable behind that wheel right now? And I think it's more Ricky Johnson being comfortable than Johnny Greaves.
Oh, and we talked about those ruts. Look at those front two trucks out of shape coming through there. Pieces falling off the front of Ricky's truck.
One thing we got to keep in mind, Jim, is that as hard as these trucks are going now, and as hard as they're landing off these jumps, they're bound to possibly break something. CVs, axles, spindles, something, as we start to get closer to the checkered flag.
Twice the amount of parts being driven by these four-wheel machines as well. So a lot more chance to break things, especially with 900 horsepower.
God bless us, more big air off the uphill jump. And Johnny Greaves up on two wheels. Totally bikes it. And now Ricky Johnson has the lead.
All right, go get him. Nice and smooth, nice and smooth. Just ride your line. You're faster than him.
I don't know how Johnny Greaves saved it after what looked like he was beyond the point of no return. Pulls it back down, back underway, but Ricky Johnson in command.
We know that Ricky's aggressive driver. We know that he likes to lead, but we also know he likes to chase guys down. Now we'll be able to see, will Johnny have something in the holster for Ricky? Can Johnny reel in our leader?
Especially Johnny being out front for almost all of this race thus far.
Well, there's another driver who can't keep out, and that's Scott Douglas right now running in third. He can't keep the old war horse down. We'll see if he's got something as well.
I'm wondering if those two huge jumps did anything to his truck.
Or him, because that is some big air. Well over 150 feet, probably about 20, 25 feet high.
And it looks like Johnny Greaves getting back into the groove, maybe closing the gap a little bit on Ricky Johnson.
You know, I happen to think right now that both our top two trucks, our former motocross riders here at this track years ago.
That line was good too, besides the wall. Three to go, come on.
The race is winding down. Johnny Greaves trying to reel in Ricky Johnson for another run at the lead.
And you can see how hard he's working, yet some kind of a cool calm with Johnny Greaves.
You know, it looks like the faster he goes, the more comfortable he is. He didn't look that comfortable when he had the lead. Now he looks so much more at ease. But he's got a long way to go to reel our leaders. One thing to catch Ricky Johnson. It's a whole other story to try and pass him.
Well, we've seen how many times that's the truth.
A little bit further back, here comes Chenny charging on Mark Jenkins.
Coming on your heart.
Chenny taps the left rear of Jenkins. Jenkins goes over hard.
You all right, Mark?
Now, what is Chenny doing?
Let me over. That was a hard one, but let me over.
It looks like Chenny's pulled off the side of the track to watch Mark to make sure he's okay.
Kind of knowing his involvement in the whole situation.
Well, you can see a full course yellow has come out.
He is okay. That is Mark. And he is okay. He's reported in. Everything is cool. Copy.
Well, that's good to hear. Now that you can see Jenkins is getting pulled back on all four wheels. Tucks his arms up to his chest so he doesn't flop around when it comes back on all four. Well, now we'll see if he's able to fire that truck back up and get back underway. As you can see, Johnny Greaves idled by. Chenny back underway as he's been signaled also that Mark is okay. Man, talk about sportsmanship, huh?
What a cool thing to do right there. So he's going to go get back in line, see what he's got for these guys. But right now, Ricky Johnson up front, Johnny Greaves second. And Scott Douglas running top three as we go back to green. What may be a green, white, checkered finish, I don't know.
Well, at least there's the green flag. Ricky Johnson gets a good jump off the line. Johnny Greaves in second, Scott Douglas third.
Lay on it.
We go on board with Johnny Greaves. He's hard on the pipe, smashing that thing down, trying to reel in Ricky Johnson.
It looks like that's exactly what is happening. opening. Greaves is definitely catching Johnson. But again, he's got to get past two separate battles.
He's been doing really good making up ground up that hill, and this time just the same.
And you know the spotters for Ricky Johnson are telling him exactly what's going on behind him. Trying to make that ram as wide as possible. Here comes Greaves inside! Oh, Greaves has a shot right there! But it looks like he thinks better of it and lifts just a little bit.
Boy, a little surprising. The door looked like it was a little wider open than that. I would have thought Johnny would have barreled right through.
And there's the white flag. Johnny's chances are running slim. And Ricky's making that ram right now as wide as possible.
With less than one to go, can Johnny Greaves make it happen again?
They both slide super crazy wide to the outside.
Looks like Ricky actually picks up a couple spots that time.
One final time up the uphill jump. Both drivers go by. Johnson still with a rather comfortable lead. That long left-hand sweeper. It looks like Ricky's pulled out the lead about two, maybe three truck lengths, but I got to go back half a lap. I think Johnny's chances were on one lap ago. They're not going to happen anymore.
You know, the way these guys have been going back and forth, I am shocked still that he didn't smash it through. Last turn of the last lap, Ricky Johnson's going to hang on and once again receive the checkered flag.
Johnny Greaves second, but once again, we mentioned it, Johnny had that one chance, didn't take it. Johnny will cross the line, minus the entire front end.
Good job, guys. I think this thing up. We got it pretty good.
Great piece of work, RJ. Great job.
Now look at this. Down goes the window net. Ricky Johnson gives Johnny Greaves a thumbs up, and Johnny doesn't return.
Wow, there's something you don't see very often. We're used to them showing each other a finger out the window, but it's not usually the thumbs.
Yeah, very good point, Jim. As the drivers make their way to the podium, this is the kind of racing we've been wanting to see out of these two guys for quite some time. And how about Scott Douglas finishing on the podium again? The man right there, still doing it, still putting it on the box. But look at our top three guys. All of that one generation, all the older guys, still showing the young guns how to do it.
And look at the fans. You think they remember their hero, Ricky Johnson?
Hey, Ricky Johnson, you know what?
What a race at RedBud!
Johnny was running phenomenal. You know, I mean, I was trying a lot of stuff and trying a lot of different lines. I thought I was making a little bit of time on him, but I wasn't reeling him in that much. And he just came in really hot and bicycled, and that's what gave me the advantage. I really didn't do anything special. I was just there I didn't make a mistake when he made a mistake. He got on the bike really, really high. It was an awesome save by him. I cut underneath him, and it gave us a little bit of gap, and then all of a sudden I'm like, damn you, Mark Jenkins, because I know Johnny and he shot on the inside, but it was a gentleman move. He came in, he didn't have a stuck. He would have been three quarters of the way. He'd have pushed me to the wall, but he's in nose there, and he backed off, and that gave me a little bit of an advantage, gave me a little bit of a resting room. But
you know, once he got by me, it seemed like we were pretty damn even, so there wasn't a whole lot, you know. Probably had a chance to do a dirty move right there, but got on the brakes and checked up and said, we're going to win this one clean if we can win it.
The downside you went up so high, I'm like, oh, he's going over, and then all of a sudden he's going out there.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Jeez, I hope he's having a good
time. Thank you. I checked up late. I was in the air. Nothing happened.
Dude, that first lap, did you see him? Yeah. Oh, I was slowing down. He kept going. I'm like, wow, he needs to go hit that long on the field.
Oh, no, you were good, because I could feel like, okay, I know it's fun to talk to me. You didn't do it fun. It was all fun. We had a good race up top going, and then it was just, man, it was cold and stuff. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So,